What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Golf Simulator Videos. We're here today with a very exciting video. This is one that a lot of the GSV users have been asking to see. This is the Flightscope Mevo Plus Pro package. We're going to do a comparison with the UNEEKOR IXO. So the reason that we're using the UNEEKOR IXO is that this is a ceiling mounted system. It's out of the way of the radar. It's not a side unit or anything that could interfere, or another radar, behind the Flightscope or next to it that can also interfere. So this gives the Flightscope Mevo Plus Pro package a really good environment to try to perform in, and it's going to compare to a camera system. UNEEKOR IXO is a dual camera infrared based ceiling mounted system that I believe is a very, very nice system. I've shown it in the channel, and we're talking about two completely different price categories. So Flightscope Mevo Plus with the Pro package comes in at $3,000, where the UNEEKOR IXO is a $10,000 unit. All right, so don't get me wrong, UNEEKOR IXO is packing a lot of features, but Flightscope Mevo Plus, being that more entry-level price point, obviously has a ton of attention from a bunch of users as well. Now, if you're looking to purchase either of these units, more than happy to help you out. Been helping a ton of people, get you the lowest price, plus save you a bunch of money on all the other components, whether it be turf or screen or projectors, anything on those lines. My partners will even help you design your space, everything. Make sure you shoot me an email. I'll pin it to the top of the comments and put it in the description. But what I have going on here today is I have the Flightscope Mevo Plus connected to the E6 Golf Simulator software. It displays the club data, all right? And I think it'd be a good opportunity to kind of, see the flight and things along those lines in this Golf Simulator software. It also is golf simulator software that's included with the Flightscope Mevo Plus. It's the iOS version, and I'm using the PC version, but you can easily upgrade to the PC version as well. And then I have the UNEEKOR IXO View software that is included with that unit. So I know it's a lot going on. I tried to shrink that down off to the side. We'll adjust that if necessary so we can review the data after we hit some shots. I do have a metal dot on my ball. I know a lot of people have asked about the RCT ball from Titleist. That is not an approved ball from Flightscope yet. That's why I'm not using it. I understand people are getting decent results, but I want to use what the OEM is recommending. That way there are no variables, where, we might have a potential, wrong reading or things along those lines. So, and then I do have the club stickers on my club for the UNEEKOR IXO. That is required to get the club data from the UNEEKOR IXO. It's a little vertical, kind of rectangle, and then a little square. All right, so let's just start off by hitting some shots. This is an 8-iron that I stickered up. I always feel like that's kind of a good middle of the road, club to use. So let's go ahead and fire off a shot. Feel like I pushed that a little bit. And I'm getting open face a 2.6 and a club path inside out 1.2 from IXO. So 2.6 and 1.2, and then I'm getting 3.5 open and 0.7 into out from the Flightscope. Now, if we want to do comparisons, we can do that just by opening up the analyzer here. And it looks like we are able to see all of that data quite well from where I have it. So I could even probably shrink that down a little bit if I wanted to, but I want to be able to see the numbers. So we'll just leave it like that. So 3.5 open versus, let me see where that club data is, 2.6 open. So a variable about 0.9. Club path 1.2 versus 0.7. All right, so there's our first shot. And then we can even play, if we wanted to, that video, which you guys get to see anyway. So if you want to, just rewind and you can replay that video to see what's going on. You can see I hit it a little bit towards the heel. All right. Try to strike this one a little bit better. I'm gonna try to get maybe a little more of a path that's zeroed out, or even a little fade. Really good strike on that one. I feel like I got it working. So face angle, right 1.9, and I did get my path working 2.2 to the left according to UNEEKOR. And then we had 4.3 open versus 1.9. And then let's pull that back up. It is a little fast. I could change the seconds that it reviews if I wanted to, but so outside in of 3 versus 2.2, and then face angle of 1.9 versus 4.3. All right, so both are showing the path and the face either, you know, both open or both inside out, with just some variables in degree from what I'm seeing so far. All right, let's try to hit a little bit of a draw, try to get this working maybe a little bit inside out, and I'll try to close my face down. All right, you can see that face kind of look closed in the picture. It says my face angle is left 0.4, so just a little bit left, and then 2.8 inside out. And looks like I can pause this actually, I think, if I just hold on to here. There we go. 0.9 closed. I thought I was pausing that. My apologies. 0.9 closed, okay, versus 0.4 closed. So very close. And then 2.8 into out versus 1.3 into out. Once again, showing very similar, at least paths, a little bit of a degree variance from what I'm seeing so far, you know, as far as both those data points. But, you know, these were the main things that people were looking for. You know, you can compare other data points. They're all available to you, you know, but the main thing I'm focusing on right now, and if you even look, you know, look at the carry, 156 versus 158. I mean, very similar carry, that's for sure. Spins are similar. All right, I'm gonna try to just hit kind of a little bit of a normal shot again. And like, this is kind of a first look at the Flightscope Mevo Plus Pro package compared to UNEEKOR IXO. We can do more. Okay, that pulled, you know, not crazy, but a little bit. Tried to swing after that pretty hard. Club path 0.5, so my path showing a little better, but a closed face of 2.4. That's why I felt that pull. Let's go back in there and just kind of pause that. So 2.6 closed versus 2.4 closed, very close. And then 1.2 out to in versus 0.5. So only, you know, 0.7 degree difference there. And then the face angle, very close to IXO that time. So I'm seeing some good results so far, and you know, I would expect some variances here. I don't expect these things to be spot on at all. I obviously, and I've mentioned in the past, I'm a big fan of the IXO's, you know, path video and impact image. You do have to be careful with the impact image. You know, it is manipulated a little bit to get that, so you can get a little bit of tweak. I wouldn't totally rely on where that face angle is in that image as much as for a ball impact. The video shows a better representation of where that club is at impact, and you can see that right here. So when that video is paused, that is at impact, and if you look at the picture, it kind of gives a little more of a representation that that is actually closed a little bit, but if you look in the video, it's not as closed. So, you know, 2 degrees closed, where that one in the picture might, you know, make you think that it's 4 degrees or so closed. All right, I'm gonna try to hit another fade, try to get it more of an outside in path going. There it is, nice little fade on the ball. This is a good demonstration for you guys to see the Flightscope Mevo Plus with some shot shaping as well. So that was left 5.9, okay. Let me bring that back up to pause it. So 5.9 out to in versus 6.3. I mean, really close. And then open, all right, 1 versus 1.8. So, you know, we're seeing, you know, this data point, you know, definitely come in, a little bit similar. Now the club face showed open on the Flightscope Mevo Plus, and I'm seeing a face angle slightly closed on the IXO. And if you look at the data representation there, looks like the IXO is probably giving you a little more accurate data. I can kind of see that face isn't open at impact. You know, and I'll, why don't I bring this up for you guys really quick? Let me bring view up here. And the only tough part is I wanna make sure I'm showing you this correctly. So let me bring this down. Because what I wanna do see how it's moving around? I just didn't want to, let me bring it down to this screen really quick and see if it will represent the same for you guys. What I was trying to do is show, that will work. I want to show this video of that outside in and then show the face a little bit. So the face does look a little closed to me at impact. And that's kind of what I was, you know, wanted to see comparison, you know, of Flightscope Mevo Plus saying it was open. And, you know, if you look at that at impact, it's almost a tiny bit closed is from what I can see, if not square, you know, so almost meeting them in the middle a little bit, if you will. You know, I'd almost say that, you know, both of them might not be perfect on face angle. I think that's obviously a very challenging, you know, data point, you know, to read. So something just to understand, you know, and that's what's nice about that IXO, you know, video replay and image is obviously that you're going to get, you know, a real look at what's going on. So both of these units, you know, appear to be giving some pretty good club data from what I'm seeing though. Love to, you know, see what you guys think, comment below. I mean, as always, especially when I do comparisons, you know, I'm hitting enough shots to where it gives a very good demonstration. You guys can look at the data, compare it, you know, for yourself, comment below, let me know what you think. When I'm doing it on the fly, sometimes I even miss something. I might not be looking at, like, look at the carry number, 143 versus 142, very, very close, but I wasn't even looking at that. So just understand, that's all. Let's go ahead and hit another one. Oh, perfect. A miss. I hit that thin. Let's see what happens there. Maybe a little bit harder to read the data on the thin shot. It says closed 1.8 and path almost, you know, straight. And then I had a little bit outside in on the Flightscope Mevo Plus. Whoops. There we go. And but both closed, 1.7, 1.8. And then just a tiny bit out to in, and then 1.3 out to in on Flightscope Mevo Plus. So even on that thin shot, which they both showed very similar carries on a thin shot, like to see that. Yeah, both of them definitely showing some similar results. You know, what I don't wanna see is I don't wanna see opposite path or opposite face angles. Because at that point, you know, if you're working on your game, you're getting, you know, something that, you know, really is kind of steering you the wrong direction. What I'm seeing right now is that I'm seeing both the units showing either very similar or both close, you know, close enough, you know, within a few degrees at max really is kind of what we've seen. Both either out to in, both in to out, or both open or both closed. So it's going to guide you in the right direction regardless. You know, we're not here to tell you what system is even the most accurate as much as, you know, they're both kind of representing what I'm telling you I'm hitting. I'll try to go a little more inside out and closed on this one. Let's almost aim a little bit right, a little bit closed face. Should have a heavy draw on that. There we go. Perfect. Perfect. That's what I wanted to do that one time. I want to start the ball to the right a little bit, bring it back to give you guys. And notice how I got more carry out of that. 156 and then 160. Let's go ahead and bring that up and compare data on that. So in to out, 8.7 versus 6.4, and then face angle showing right two versus pretty square on Flightscope Mevo Plus. And then if you look at the actual image on the UNEEKOR system, it's questionable on the face angle, honestly, if you look at that. It almost looks a little more square. So it could go both ways. I mean, it definitely could. Obviously, the way I hit that ball, both of them read that big inside-out path. And face angle, you know, could be close on that one. You know, I felt like it was kind of in between what both are saying. So, you know, not like it would be far off on that. And the paths both look, you know, very similar. So, I mean, we're already working on 15 minutes here. I try to keep the videos a realistic length. I'd love to know what you guys think on this. This is our first look video showing the Flightscope Mevo Plus Pro package with comparison to the UNEEKOR IXO. We're talking about club data today, you know, really focusing on path and face angle. almost everybody that reached out to me. I mean, sure, there's always unique requests for each, you know, maybe individual thing, but most people said, I really just want to know if the path and the face angle are going to be similar, you know, when I'm using my Flightscope Mevo Plus, you know, more to a high-end system. So UNEEKOR IXL, even though it's an overhead unit, which is a little harder to read the path and the face, it does obviously a pretty good job, and we can kind of verify that with the video, you know, more than the image, like I was mentioning before. But I'll tell you what, they're both showing, you know, either similar paths or similar face angles on most of the shots, given some variables in there. You know, it was a very interesting comparison. I'm glad we did this today. I'd love to know what you guys think. Make sure you comment below and let me know if there's anything else you'd like to see. I'll try to squeeze it in. Been very busy lately, but, you know, trying to, you know, release some new videos with all the, you know, new software updates and things along those lines. I think I'll have a video coming up here soon. I'd like to cover the Flightscope Mevo Plus new FS Golf software that has been released. You know, I don't know if it'll be optimal for indoor because of the chipping and putting and everything, but we will take a look at that and see if that'd be a good video either for now, or maybe we'll do it outside when the weather gets better. So as always, I appreciate you guys watching. Make sure you stay tuned because we'll have more coming soon.